Yes, I know, just as surprised as you guys. The last couple days, I have gone full-on roadie testing out the new SRAM Rival Axis electronic shifting group set. So Axis Rival is supposed to be the most accessible from a price perspective electronic shifting system that SRAM offers. And while it's definitely less expensive than their other offerings, it does cost a bit of coin. So you can go one buy for just under $1,200 or two buy for just under $1,500 without the power meter crankset. Because it is part of the Axis system, you could, in theory, run this Rode shifter with the recently released GX system as well. Still not cheap, but less eye-wateringly expensive than previous iterations. So you guys know I'm not a roadie, so even a lot of the options that they offer with the Rival are kind of right over my head. From my perspective as a non-roadie, the things I'm most excited about are the crankset. You can get them in 4330, and they released recently a 10 to 36 cassette to work with all this new electronic goodness. That's probably the most significant upgrade to me. I'm not too concerned that it's, you know, 300 grams heavier than Force or that it has a power meter, but in this iteration, it actually has decently low gears. For whatever reason, most Rode group sets will approach one-to-one gearing but won't go below. But with this setup, 4330 in the front and 10 to 36 in the back, you actually get pretty dang good low gears. It's lower, in fact, than the common 4630 compact double paired with a 10 to 34. Finally, there is decently low gears in electronic shifting package for a 2x. If we're talking gear inches, you get a top gear inch of 113 gear inches, which is pretty tall, and a low gear inch of 22.2. So while definitely not as low geared as a touring bike, it's definitely lower than many road bikes out there. To put it in perspective, the typical budget mullet gearing I run is with a 38 tooth in the front and 11 to 50 in the rear, and that gives me a low gear of 20.4. And so for this to be about 22 gear inches, it's pretty dang close to what I would run on my Crest Bimbora. And if you're wondering why I'm obsessed with low gears, my background is usually in touring, and in the touring bike world, people actually try to shoot for about 14, 15 gear inches in their lowest gear because you never know what's going to happen. You could be carrying 100 pounds of gear up and over a 10,000 foot mountain pass. And in those circumstances, you definitely want low gears. So that really conditioned me to value low gears more than the top end gear. That's where I'm coming from, just in case you're about to write a comment, why would you ever need such low gears? So this bike came fully assembled with the group set already installed. And one of the things I was really curious about was how easy or difficult it would be to get everything up and running. It's surprisingly easy. I just had to charge up the batteries and slap them into the respective derailleurs and hit some buttons, and it just spoke to each other. And no need for an app, although you can use an app to kind of customize the experience. In terms of how it feels, you gotta know that I'm coming from a mechanical shifting background. I have ridden other Axis setups in the past, but not long enough to form a really strong opinion. In the few rides that I have taken this out on, it has shifted flawlessly, no misshift. If you've never used a SRAM electronic shifting system, the left shifter shifts to the lower gears and the right shifter shifts to the harder gears. And if you hit them both at the same time, it will manipulate the front derailleur. I will say one thing I did notice when I was doing single shifts is that it felt like there was a tiny bit of lag. I don't have the resources to accurately time it, but just in terms of feel, I feel like it took just a couple milliseconds longer. And I don't know if that's because I'm so used to a mechanical system and kind of preloading the shifter and just feeling the tension of the spring that when I do shift, it feels instantaneous. As opposed to this, there's not a whole lot of mechanical feedback, so you feel a little bit disconnected from the actual movement of the rear derailleur. Shifting felt a lot quicker when I just did a long press and shift across the cassette, but it was in those one click, one shift instances where I felt like it wasn't quite as snappy as a nicely tuned cable derailleur. For testing, I took it on my favorite gravel loop here in Missoula, which involves a paved climb, then a gravel climb, and then a gravel descent. It definitely pitches in the upper double digits, so about 14-16% over some loose gravel, which I think is a fairly good test for any drivetrain. And I have to say, I was pleasantly surprised. Just when I thought I was out of gears, I would look down and there would be one more shift available. So I'm pretty impressed with the low gearing options. I don't think it's quite low enough if you're going on a super super rugged tour in the mountains, carrying a bunch of stuff, but definitely for event rides, gravel riding, road riding, maybe super light touring where you don't have climbs of double digits that go on forever. The gear range, pretty dang good. Of course, if I had my druthers, you know, I'd easily sacrifice the gear inches from 100 to 113 to get more lower end, but that's just because that's how I ride and that's the gearing I prefer. So what are the pros and cons so far? One big pro is the ease of setup. I was stoked that I didn't really have to use a phone. I hate being tied to other electronics. I just want to go out and ride. Another big pro, and quite a bit of a surprise to me, is that it's actually got decently low gears. If you run a 4630, you know, 11 to 34 tooth cassette, this will actually be lowered geared. Another big pro is that it is a little bit more accessible than other options. By no means is $1,200 for a 1x or $1,500 for a 2x drivetrain cheap, but relative to what's out there on the market, if you do want to get your electronic shifting on, then this is a pretty viable option. Those are the pros. What are the cons? So the first big con is, yes, while it is more attainable, it is still pretty dang expensive. It's going to be really interesting to see the price points of bikes in the future that include this as an OEM option. I have a feeling it's going to be a pretty popular spec build, and it will get more people trying out electronic shifting. Another con is to save money and also shrink down the form factor of the levers. They did get rid of blip compatibility. So that's the ability to run little satellite shifters wherever you want to put them. This is a bit of a bummer in terms of an accessibility standpoint. Let's say if you only have function of one arm or one hand, this would have been a great, more affordable option, but as it is, if you want to use those satellite shifters, you still have to go upmarket to either Force or Red. Another big downside for me is that this is hydraulic only and flat mount only. So if you've got a weird bike like I do, the Crest of Embora, where it's half flat mount, half post mount, out of the box, this won't work. You can change the caliper, but that is at an added cost. I personally would have loved to see this with a mechanical brake offering. That might have lowered the costs and also made it more accessible for people with bikes with strange configurations like me or want to run their own brakes. Hydraulics are great, 100% for mountain biking, but I don't think they're absolutely necessary for road or gravel. I think a cable brake offering would have made me more of a fan, but the fact that you're locked into hydros only and flat mount only kind of limits the bikes that you can use this group set with to only the most recent and most modern bikes. Overall, with my very short time with this group set, I am impressed with the ease of setting it up and also the low gears. That's a big plus, and I applaud SRAM for finally not being afraid to dip below that one-to-one barrier. It seems like lots of road group sets will tiptoe to that line but just won't commit, but they did it with this one with that 10 to 36 rear cassette. I think it's also a great option if you want to mix and match these shifters with the newly released GX Axis rear derailleurs. I think it's definitely a compelling group set. If I had that GCN money, I'd probably pull the trigger on it. But for me, still outside of the budget I would want to spend on a group set. And I know it's a bit of a pipe dream, but would love to see this with a mechanical brake version. It would lower the price and make it easier to install on bikes for home mechanics like myself that have some knowledge but don't want to get messy with dot fluid. That's what I think. Let me know what you guys think about this new SRAM Rival Axis group set in the comments below. If you have any other questions, leave those in the comments. I'll be sure to try to answer them. And if you like this content, this perspective, be sure to check out the merch store, buy some stickers and some patches. We're 100% supported by you guys, the viewers. And as always, keep the supple side down.